of Foreign Language of Indira Gandhi National Open University presents a program on familiarization of French language for the beginners of language learning students.
J'ai acheté un cadeau pour ma sœur.
Vous pouvez me dire ce que vous en pensez?
Parfait alors.
Qu'est-ce que c'est?
Un sac à main.
Je l'ai acheté au marché.
Il est très joli, ça va lui plaire.
Il a coûté cher?
Non, c'était un prix raisonnable.
Parfait alors.
Do you know in which language these people are talking? Is it Spanish, Swedish, Russian or any other language? This is French language. Today we're going to discuss all that you have learnt in the previous programs. You have learnt a lot of new words and grammatical rules in French. And now we're going to explain them further. Our topic is short conversation in a shop. A client wants to purchase a laptop and asks advices to the salesman. You already should know how to ask questions, so now you have to focus on vocabulary regarding situations when you have to buy something. You will hear conversation in which people speak about euros to pay. Indeed, in France, euro is the only currency available since 2002. Let's start by listening to a conversation between a client and a salesman.
Good afternoon, madame. Can I help you?
Bonjour, madame. Je peux vous aider?
Good afternoon. Yes, I want to buy a small laptop to travel more easily, but I need advices.
Bonjour. Oui, je veux acheter un petit ordinateur pour voyager plus facilement. Mais j'ai besoin de conseils.
What do you want?
Qu'est-ce que vous voulez?
Actually, I already have one, but I want a smaller laptop.
En fait, j'en ai déjà un, mais je veux un ordinateur plus petit.
There is this one. It's the lightest.
Il y a celui-là. C'est le plus léger.
And is it the smallest?
Et est-ce que c'est le moins gros?
Yes, it is.
Oui, c'est ça.
What is the price of this laptop?
Quel est le prix de cet ordinateur?
It costs 500 euros.
500 euros.
Oh, it's too expensive. Do you have a laptop less expensive?
Oh, c'est trop cher. Est-ce que vous avez des ordinateurs moins chers?
Yes, there is one. It costs 400 euros, but it's heavier.
Oui, il y en a un, mais il est plus lourd.
It's true, but it's okay. I take this one. Can I pay by card?
C'est vrai, mais ça va. Je prends celui-là. Je peux payer par carte?
Yes, madame. So, 400 euros.
Oui, madame. Alors, 400 euros.
Here is my card.
Voici ma carte.
Thanks, madame. And have a good afternoon.
Merci, madame. Et passez une bonne après-midi.
Thanks. Bye.
Merci. Au revoir.
In this conversation, there are lots of words used for comparison. Have you noticed the construction? To say that something is more expensive, bigger, taller, etc. than other thing, you have to use plus before the adjective or plus before the adjective. For example, a smaller laptop is translated un ordinateur plus petit. To say more easily, you say plus facilement. So, plus or plus. P-L-U-S, P-L-U-S is the translation of more. You also have to know that the most or words having the same meaning like the lightest is translated le plus, le plus. For example, the lightest is translated le plus léger. And the most famous is translated by le plus connu. It is the same construction for sentences like the less famous. The less famous is translated as le moins connu. Less is translated by moins, M-O-I-N-S or M-O-E-N-S, like in the sentence, Do you have laptops less expensive? Which can be translated by
Est-ce que vous avez des ordinateurs moins chers?
To try to better understand it, listen to the same conversation in French only. After each sentence, try to repeat the words used for comparison.
Bonjour madame, je peux vous aider?
Bonjour, oui, je veux acheter un petit ordinateur pour voyager plus facilement. Mais j'ai besoin de conseils.
Plus facilement.
Qu'est-ce que vous voulez?
En fait, j'en ai déjà un. Mais je veux un ordinateur plus petit.
Plus petit.
Il y a celui-là. C'est le plus léger.
Le plus léger.
Est-ce que c'est le moins gros?
Le moins gros.
Oui, c'est ça.
Et quel est le prix de cet ordinateur?
Il coûte 500 euros.
Oh, c'est trop cher. Est-ce que vous avez des ordinateurs moins chers?
Moins chers.
Oui, il y en a un, mais il est plus lourd.
Plus lourd.
C'est vrai, mais ça va. Je prends celui-là. Je peux payer par carte?
Oui, madame. Alors, 400 euros.
Voici ma carte.
Merci, madame. Et passez une bonne après-midi.
Merci. Au revoir.
To compare things in French, the most important words are
plus, moins,
or in the superlative,
le plus
and
le moins.
In this program, we have learned how to purchase something and to ask prices. We have also learned four words used for comparison.
Today, for cultural aspects of France, we want to speak about the Eiffel Tower, because the monument is known in the whole world as the symbol of Paris. The Eiffel Tower has been built between 1887 and 1889 by Gustave Eiffel, who has also participated in the construction of the Statue of Liberty in New York. His name, Gustave Eiffel, is spelled as G-U-S-T-A-V-E, Gustave, and Eiffel, E-I-D-E-U-X-F-E-L. The nickname of the Eiffel Tower is La Dame de Fer, meaning the Iron Lady. Indeed, this tower is made of steel, so it is very heavy, weighing 7,000 tons. It is 300 meters in height, approximately 1,063 feet. And since it is made of steel, its size can change by 15 centimeters due to changes in the temperature. If the weather is hot, the iron can stretch, but the weather is cold, it can retract. The Eiffel Tower is the most visited paid monument in the world, with about 7 million tourists each year. Since 1889, 250 million tourists visited the tower. One can climb up the Eiffel Tower. It has 1,792 steps. There are also four lifts installed to go up the tower. And from the top of the tower, one gets a beautiful panoramic view of Paris. Finally, let's speak about the French culture. You may know lots of stereotypes on French people. For example, when we think about French, we think about their gastronomy or their wines. We are going to speak about some wines in France, like red wine, white wine, and rose. France is famous for its wide variety of wines. Indeed, even if other countries like Spain, Italy, or even countries of South America produce wines, France is viewed as the country of the wine because it is the biggest producer of wine in the world. It is said there is wine in France since the 6th century before Christ, thanks to the Greeks who settled in the south of France. Today, around 800 vineyards in France producing more than 3,400 different wines. Wine is made in different parts of France, which can be understood by looking at the varieties of terroirs. Let's spell this word terroir. T-E-V-O-R-O-I-R, terroir. The word terroir, T-E as you heard just now, spelling in French. Let's repeat it in English. T-E-double-R-O-I-R. The word terroir refers to a geographical part, but also includes other factors like the weather, the quality of the ground, etc. Nowadays, we count 13 famous terroirs: Alsace, Beaujolais, Bordeaux, Beaujon,
Champagne, Core, Jura, Languedoc, Roussillon, Provence, Savoy, Loire Valley, Rhone Valley and the terroir of the southwest. As you can see in any map of France, each terroir is in a region. Most of them are in the southern part of the country.
You're just listening to a program entitled Short Conversation in a Shop. A client wants to purchase a laptop and asks advices to the salesman. In this program, we have learned how to purchase something and to ask prices. We also have learned four words used for comparison. To compare things in French, the most important words are
plus, moins,
or the superlatives
le plus
and
le moins.
In this program, the participants were Juliet Aracle, Lalema Aneja Dang, D. Andrews, Dr. Sushant Kumar Mishra, Isora Buisson Brule, and Tiffane Amar. Program concept and scripted by Manoj Kumar Singh, Dr. Sushant Kumar Mishra, and Isora Buisson Brule. Program content coordinator, Dr. Sushant Kumar Mishra. Sound recording by Parvesh Kumari and edited by Sadhan Lal. Produced by Manoj Kumar Singh. This program was brought to you by Electronic Media Production Center of the Indira Gandhi National Open University.
Did you know? India is the world's largest tea producer and tea is its most popular beverage. Interesting facts brought to you by NCITE in collaboration with EMPC Division, IGNO. Thank you.